Already one of the most powerful Dark Lords to have joined the ranks of the Sith, Darth Bane's acquisition of his Orbalisk armor ensured that he was an adherent to the dark side who was virtually unstoppable. Although it had some drawbacks, the Orbalisk armor provided Bane with unprecedented benefits in both healing and in strengthening his connection to the dark side, thereby making him even more powerful. In this video expose, I will describe Darth Bane's unique Orbalisk armor, how he came to acquire it, and the beneficial attributes it provided him to make Bane virtually unstoppable. Following Darth Bane's eradication of the entire Sith Order during the Seventh Battle of Rusyn, at the culmination of the new Sith Wars, Bane and his new apprentice Darth Sana searched the remnants of the Sith camp on Rusyn. Bane hoped that the search would provide him with knowledge, or at the very least instructions and clues, that would be useful to his new plan for the Sith, underpinned by his philosophy of the Rule of Two. During his search of the camp, Bane discovered a manuscript referencing an ancient Dark Lord named Freedon Nadd, wherein notes were made that indicated that Nadd was buried on the moon of Zun. Hoping to discover secrets of the ancient Dark Lord and become stronger in the dark side, Bane traveled to the moon to examine the tomb of Freedon Nadd. Having journeyed to Zun, Bane was successful in locating Nadd's tomb. Even more importantly, Bane was able to locate the holocron of the ancient Dark Lord. However, as Bane attempted to claim Nadd's holocron for himself, he was attacked by numerous small creatures in the holocron's chamber. Despite his best efforts, Bane was unable to keep the creatures away, with many attaching themselves directly to him and causing Bane to suffer from perpetual pain as the creatures began piercing his skin. As Bane would come to learn from studying Nadd's holocron, the creatures who attacked him were called Orbalisks. Orbalisks were parasites that would congregate in large groups and lay inactive in dark places, such as the Caves of Zun where Bane was confronted by them, until they located a host in which they would attach themselves to and feed upon. Ultimately, as the Orbalisks were attached to their host, they would grow and multiply until they eventually covered the entirety of the host, and killing it through suffocation. However, unlike other typical hosts who would fall prey to the Orbalisks, Bane was able to remain alive by allowing them to feed off of the dark side energy present within him. This was a quality that was inherent to the parasitic Orbalisks, but which may have also been the result of the Orbalisks' residence upon the moon of Zun. Because the moon was a significant focus of the dark side, Orbalisks acquired the ability to feed off of a dark side user's force sensitivity. However, as Darth Bane would come to realize, the parasites provided far greater advantages than drawbacks, and thus, he would come to wear and rely upon his Orbalisk armor for the next 10 years. One of the primary advantages that the armor provided Bane was in its defensive characteristics as invaluable armor. This was because the shells of the Orbalisks were completely impenetrable and extremely durable. In fact, they were so strong that they could even defend against lightsaber blows, thereby providing the wearer with an impervious suit of armor immune to lightsabers. Because Bane was practically untouchable within his impenetrable suit, he was able to employ a vicious, completely offensive style of Jem'Sō when engaged in lightsaber combat, allowing him to focus entirely on offense and use his already tremendous physical strength to overwhelm opponents and dominate lightsaber combat. The Orbalisk armor also provided Bane with a constant and substantial surge of adrenaline and other powerful enzymes into his bloodstream, allowing him to become even more powerful through the ability to increasingly draw upon more dark side energy. In addition to strengthening Bane's connection to the dark side, the Orbalisks that made up his armor also boosted his physical strength, as the chemical enhancements provided by the armor increased Bane's senses, speed, strength, and stamina. This only furthered the power of Bane's offensive fury while engaged in lightsaber combat. Outside of just the chemical enhancements that were directly pumped into Bane, the Orbalisks also increased the Dark Lord's connection to the dark side and his combat abilities, simply through the pain that they caused him, which had the result of fueling his rage. The Orbalisk armor also made Bane virtually unstoppable through the powerful healing abilities it provided him. Separate from the chemicals that the armor provided Bane that would increase his physical attributes, it also released chemicals into him that offered Bane powerful healing abilities. These chemicals allowed Bane to heal himself instantly from a wide range of wounds. In testing the healing properties of the Orbalisk armor, Bane found that a self-inflicted knife wound healed almost as quickly as he was making it. But more importantly, the Orbalisk armor allowed Bane to quickly heal from even more debilitating and potentially deadly wounds, such as those caused by powerful lightsaber strikes. Even these more serious injuries would heal in seconds through the powerful chemical enhancements of the Orbalisk armor. It should be noted that attempting to remove the Orbalisk armor was extremely dangerous. This was because if removal was attempted, either by directly detaching them or killing them, the Orbalisks would unleash a highly potent and deadly toxin into the body of the host, something that even Bane could not survive on his own. Ultimately, Bane would lose his Orbalisk armor when his own Force Lightning was redirected back onto him, thereby killing the Orbalisks and freeing him. So there we have it, how Darth Bane's Orbalisk armor made him virtually unstoppable. We love making these videos, so why not subscribe for more fun Star Wars theories and discussions? Also, if you enjoyed the video, think about giving a like or leaving a comment. If not for me... for the greatest duel ever!